All right, guys. So, yeah, the story started in Bintan at Nuala Gardens Resort. It's a resort in Bintan. So, yeah. Anyway, it was our third and last full day before we head back to Singapore the next day. So, what happened was we decided. Well, okay. After breakfast, we went to this like high elements area and we had like fun. And I'm actually used to toilet in using the zip line. That's literally the most fastest and most efficient way possible. That was awesome, my guys. I enjoyed it. I had to relieve my bladder after going on that fun joyride. Okay, guys, I nearly pissed my pants, by the way. So you guys have to excuse me. But what happened was, after that, we went back to the hotel room to get ready. And then after lunch, we went to this like paintball area, which was fun. I destroyed everybody there, literally. So, yeah. After that, we head back to the hotel room and we prepare for dinner. Basically, what's going on is that in my school camp during my old school, we had this like themed dinners every last night of the camp. So, since this was the third and last night we'll ever have in that resort. We were gonna like celebrate it. So the theme this year, during that year, was Halloween. So we got dressed in all these types of like ghosts and everything. So, guys, hear me out. So yeah, I dressed up something that's not like really original. But yeah, anyway, once we got ready, we head to the lobby. And once we reached the lobby, we smelled this like Frankie Penny smell. So you guys don't know, it's a flower that grows in very creepy places around Malaysia and Indonesia, maybe even Singapore as well. Anyway, I was just wondering, well, okay, that's actually kind of cool. Like, weird smell. Like, I thought it was the hotel lobby smell. And I saw this student who was dressed up in this super cool costume. And it was a type of, like, some Sadako-looking character from The Ring, you guys. So, yeah, I walked up to her and asked her what she's dressed up as. Because she's got the freaking, like, contact lenses and everything. And then she told me that she dressed up as a pontianak, so I'm like, oh, cool. And during that time, I didn't know what a pontianak is, and that that was a very, very, very not smart thing to do. Like, just hop in any country in East Sentara and not know the types of hantu there is. Like, there's a lot of hantu in Southeast Asia, but that one, holy shit, guys. So, we eventually left the lobby after quite a few hours of waiting. It was already sundown by then, but there's still enough light to where we can actually see where we're going. Obviously, we have our torches and everything. So, the hanky panty smell quickly dissolved into this nasty, like, fucking rotten flesh smell. And everybody was whinging, and we passed the elephant trail. There was an elephant trail, by the way, in the resort. We passed it, and then my third eye kicked in, literally, and I just saw something white just zoom past the bushes and the trees. So I'm just like, the fuck was that? And obviously I was hoping it won't spoil my fun, so I carried on, even though inside I was just like, the hell did I just saw back there? And the smell was worse in the elephant trail. And basically we walked all the way to the area where we can eat. There's like these super cool like tombstones just like laid around the thing. We had a lot of fun. We did the skit and everything. And then after the skit and after our food, we head back to the lobby, and Lameki, which is my roommate, we decided to head back to the lobby to let the others have their fun. And Nicholas, oh yeah, guys, Nicholas and I are cool now. You guys don't know who he is. Just look at my other channel, you'll find out. Yeah, we're cool now. Anyway, So I wasn't feeling too good. You know that sensation clairvoyance get when they caught a glimpse of something paranormal and they're just completely on edge? That was me. I was just like, okay, let's just get this over with so I can get to bed quickly. And then suddenly I heard this like quack noise on the way, so I just looked to the trees because I was like, yep, this is not normal, what the fuck's going on? And my friend, we spotted our science teacher, and then at that point I thought I didn't say really, but yeah, it's just delaying the inevitable. So we got back to the hotel, and then I heard another quack, so I'm just like, oh my god, what is going on? So I just warned my friends, guys, let's just head back quickly. I don't want to be here when there's something creepy. And then the motherfucker, who I'm not going to name for obvious reasons, he decided to drop this, like, story. Like, I'm already on edge for the last few signs. I'm just like, yep, there's clearly something unclean there. And then he just drops this story. I'm just like, yo, what the fuck, man? Come on, really? When I'm this on edge? Come on. And then, the part which I was just like, yo, come on, some friend, my roommate and my classmate, he decides to chime in on the, so I had two people telling me that there's something creepy, like there's like a werewolf eating little kids there, and I'm just like, okay, stop guys, you're freaking me the fuck out. And then I heard the third quack noise, and then I smelled this rotting flesh smell mixed with the hanky panty smell, and I saw the same fucking white thing just hover past. And I saw the black hair and everything. I was just like, yo, no. I yelled, I can't take this anymore. And I screamed that the teacher who accompanied us name. And I should have told them that there was something unclean going on. But what I said was the dude told me the scary story. Now I don't think I'll be able to sleep. And I'm sorry. If you're watching this, I'm sorry. What I actually saw was a freaking ghost. So I'm very sorry if I got you in trouble. I know you weren't able to attend the next camp, but I'm very sorry, okay? What I wanted to say was I saw a ghost, but I couldn't because none of the teachers believed in me. But yeah, I'm very sorry if I got you in trouble. Anyway, yeah, that was great. I had to be escorted back to my room, and literally, I just could not, like the last possible thing I could do was think about sleeping. And I just literally just told Lemeki, like, come on, yo, man, come on, I can't sleep. Like, I can't sleep after this. There's something wrong with this hotel. And he said, come on, there's no werewolves here. And I was like, yeah, I know. But inside, I was like, yeah, I fucking know. Like, no fucking shit, there's no werewolves in this hotel. What I'm worried about is something even worse. And basically, after 5 minutes of just comfort and, like them comforting me, I managed to pluck up enough courage to hit the hay. And during that few hours, I was just having fun, and then I woke up at about 3:33 a.m., which is basically the fuck this shit o'clock for me, because, yeah, anyway, I woke up to this, like, loud, like, it sounded like singing, but at the same time, it sounded really raspy, so I'm just like, the fuck's going on, and I can hear fireworks, someone's wondering, it has to be the karaoke, but, lo and motherfucking behold, I heard the fourth quack that night, and I'm just like, okay, what? And then to make matters worse, I heard this noise. So at this moment, I was completely wide awake. I turned to the window where Lemiki was sleeping there, and holy shit, guys. I saw this, like, woman, hair completely covering her, the top part of her body. She was wearing this white gown that's streaming with blood. Her eyes were literally glowing red, and I was just like, yo, what the hell is that? What the fuck is that? Of course, I just stared there, jaw open, and just like, what? And, like, I was wide awake, and I sat up, and I'm just like, no, this can't be happening, this can't be fucking happening. And, basically, I was glad that I couldn't even go out, but yeah. Anyway, I managed to sleep, and next day, Lemiki told me that he heard some very, like, this sweet, like, singing in Bahasa, Indonesia, or Bahasa Melayu, depending on the region, and I was just like, dude, you don't have no idea what I experienced that night.